We need to solve this quadratic equation x squared plus 4x minus 5 equal to 0. We have learned how to solve a quadratic equation by factoring this expression on the left hand side. We have also learned how to solve a quadratic equation if we have a perfect square on the left hand side and a constant term on the right hand side. So if we have a perfect square on the left hand side and a constant term on the right hand side, we can take the square root of both sides and solve the equation. In this case, we have a constant that is 0 on the right hand side, but the left hand side is not a perfect square. So if we can make this left hand side a perfect square, we can solve by taking the square root of both the sides. So let us try and see if we can make the left hand side a perfect square. So first, take this negative 5 to the right hand side. So we have taken this to the right hand side. We get x squared plus 4x equal to 5. Now this is x whole square. 4x can be written as 2 into x into 2. So we have this is equal to 5. 4x is 2 into x into 2. Why x? Because we have the square of x here. So this is what we have. Now this is in the form of a square. This is in the form of 2 into a into b. If we have a b square term here, then we can represent the left hand side as a plus b whole square. We already have an a square term. We have a 2ab term. So if we have a b square term, we can represent the left hand side as a plus b whole square. We have taken x to be a, so 2 will be b. So if we have a plus 2 square here, this will become x plus 2 whole square. But if we add a 2 square here, in order to maintain the equality, we need to add a 2 square to the right hand side as well. So we add 2 square to both the sides. Now left hand side becomes x plus 2 whole square. So you can expand it and check that you get the same thing. This is x plus 2 whole square. And right hand side is 5 plus 2 square. 2 square is 4. So 5 plus 4 equal to 9. So this is what we have. Now the left hand side is a perfect square. Right hand side is a constant. So we can solve this by taking the square root of both the sides. So we take square root of left hand side, that is root over x plus 2 whole square, is equal to the square root of the right hand side, and we consider both the positive and negative sign. So this is what we have. Now root over x plus 2 whole square is x plus 2. This is equal to plus minus root over 9 is 3. So this is what we have. So x plus 2 is equal to plus minus 3. We get two equations from here. X plus 2 is equal to plus 3 and x plus 2 equal to negative 3. So these are the two equations which we get from here. Now we can solve these two equations and get the values of x. So solving this, we get x is equal to 3 minus 2. That is, x is equal to 1. And by solving this, we get x is equal to negative 3 minus 2, or x is equal to negative 5. So x equal to 1 and x equal to negative 5 is the solution of this equation. And we have derived this solution by the method of completing the square. So this method is known as the method of completing the square. In this method, we take the constant term to the right hand side and then we form a perfect square on the left hand side, take the square root of both the sides and solve for x. This method is known as completing the square because we form a complete square or a perfect square on the left hand side and solve by taking the square root of both the sides. Now let us try and solve this equation by the method of completing the square. So we have 2x squared minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. Let us take this constant term plus 3 to the right hand side. So we get 2x squared minus 5x equal to negative 3. So this is what we have. Now the first term is 2x square. It is not a perfect square. It is 2 into x square. So if we can get rid of this 2, it will become a perfect square. And how can we get rid of this 2? By dividing it by 2. So we need to divide both the sides by 2. So dividing both the sides by 2, we get x square minus 5 by 2x is equal to negative 3 by 2. This is what we have. Now concentrate on the left hand side. Left hand side is x whole square minus 2 into x. Now 5 by 2x is equal to 2 into x into 5 by 4. Now our aim here is to write the left hand side as a perfect square. So this is x square. So we can represent it as a square. Now we require a minus 2ab term. So we have minus 2. Since we have already taken x as a, we write x here, 2 into a into b. So 5 by 4 becomes our b. This is x whole square minus 2 into x into something. Now if we have this something square here, so we can write it as a square minus 2ab plus b square. So x square minus 2 into x into this number plus the square of this number will make the left hand side a perfect square. But if we add this to the left hand side, we need to add it to the right hand side as well. We have 5 by 4 here. So if we add a 5 by 4 square to the left hand side, we need to add 5 by 4 whole square to the right hand side as well. So let us add 5 by 4 whole square to both the sides. This is what we have. So we add 5 by 4 whole square to both the sides. Now this is in the form of a square minus 2 into a into b plus b square. So we can write it as a minus b whole square. That is x minus 5 by 4 whole square. And on the right hand side, we have negative 3 by 2 plus 5 by 4 whole square. 5 square is 25. 4 square is 16. And let us simplify this. So the LCM of 2 and 16 is 16. 2 into 8 is 16. Negative 3 into 8 is 24. Plus 25. This is equal to 1 by 16. So the right hand side is 1 by 16. So we have x minus 5 by 4 whole square is equal to 1 by 16. Now we have the square of something is equal to a constant term. So let us take the square root of both the sides. Taking the square root of this side, we will have x minus 5 by 4. And the square root of this side will be plus minus root over 1 by 16, which is equal to plus minus root over 1 is 1, root over 16 is 4. So plus minus 1 by 4. So we have x minus 5 by 4 is equal to plus minus 1 by 4. Now we get two equations from here. X minus 5 by 4 is equal to plus 1 by 4 and x minus 5 by 4 is equal to negative 1 by 4. So let us solve for x from both these equations. This equation gives x is equal to 5 by 4 plus 1 by 4, which is equal to 6 by 4. And we can simplify it to write x is equal to 3 by 2. So x is equal to 3 by 2. And from this equation, we have x is equal to 5 by 4 minus 1 by 4. 5 minus 1 is 4. So we have 4 by 4. So we can simplify it to write x is equal to 1. So we have x equal to 1. So this and this is the solution of this equation. We have got this solution by the method of completing the square. Note that this x square term was not a perfect square to start with, but we divided the entire equation with the coefficient of x square, which is 2. We made the coefficient of x square 1 and then used the method of completing the square to solve this equation. Now we have this equation, so let us try and solve it using the method of completing the square. So first take this constant term to the right hand side. We have 3x squared minus 11x is equal to negative 6. Now note that this is not a perfect square. So in order to make it a perfect square, we can either divide it by 3. So if we divide all the terms by 3, we can make it a perfect square. Also, if we multiply it by 3, it will become 3 square into x square. That is 3x whole square, which is again a perfect square. So we can either divide it by 3 or multiply it by 3. So let us multiply it by 3. So we need to multiply both the sides of the equation in order to maintain the equality. So we multiply both the sides of the equation by 3. 3 into 3x squared is 9x squared. 11x into 3 is 33x. Negative 6 into 3 is negative 18. This is what we have. Now, 9x squared is 3x whole square. Minus 2 into 3x. Now we have 33x. 33x can be written as 2 into 3x. We have got this 3x from here. So 2 into 3x into 11 by 2. 2 into 3x into 11 by 2 gives 33x. So we have 3x whole square minus 2 into 3x into 11 by 2. If we have an 11 by 2 square here, the left hand side will become a perfect square. A square minus 2ab plus b square. So this will become a perfect square. Since we have added 11 by 2 whole square to the left hand side, we need to add the same thing to the right hand side as well. So this is what we have. Now, this is in the form of a minus b whole square. So we write it as 3x minus 11 by 2 whole square is equal to negative 18 plus 11 square is 121, 2 square is 4. So this is what we have. This is equal to 3x minus 11 by 2 whole square equal to, take the LCM, 4, 4 into negative 18 is negative 72, and we have plus 121. 121 minus 72 is 49. 121 minus 72 is 49. So we have 49 by 4. So this is what we have. Now we have it in the form of something square equal to a constant. So we can take the square root of both the sides. So let us take the square root of both the sides. This is equal to 3x minus 11 by 2 is equal to plus minus root over 49 by 4. Remember that we need to consider both the positive and negative signs, which is equal to plus minus root over 49 is 7. And root over 4 is 2. So we have plus minus 7 by 2. So we get 3x minus 11 by 2 equal to plus minus 7 by 2. Now we get these two equations from here. 3x minus 11 by 2 equal to plus 7 by 2. And 3x minus 11 by 2 equal to negative 7 by 2. So solving these two equations, we can find the value of x. This gives 3x is equal to 11 by 2 plus 7 by 2 is 18 by 2. 18 by 2 is 9. So 3x equal to 9. Or we can say that x is equal to 9 by 3, which is 3. So x equal to 3. We have x equal to 3 from here. Now from this, we have 3x equal to 11 by 2 minus 7 by 2. So 11 by 2 minus 7 by 2 is 4 by 2. 4 by 2 is 2. So 3x equal to 2. Or x is equal to 2 by 3. This is what we have. X equal to 2 by 3. So x equal to 3 and x equal to 2 by 3 is the solution of this equation. So we have solved this equation by the method of completing the square. So now you see that we can solve any quadratic equation. Remember, any quadratic equation by the method of completing the square. With factoring, at times it may take a lot of time and effort to arrive at the correct factor. But using the method of completing the square, we can very easily solve any quadratic equation.